Hey guys, we just reconfigured our live streaming studio for a 3-camera interview shoot, and I want to show you how it was set up. So as you can see here, we've got two kind of cool chairs that really pop off of our red brick, and we've got blue lights really showing it here. And what we're gonna do here is we're gonna have a 3-camera shoot. This is the standard interview shoot. We are showing a 20x Zcam for our centered shot because we don't need to do any pan tilt zoom really, and the 20x Zcam models color match perfectly with the 20x SDI PTZ cameras. So up here you can see we've got our PTZ models, and these allow us to zoom and pan and, you know, move around a little bit as we capture our cross shots. So it's really professional to have a 3-camera shoot. You start with two people in the shot, then you do a cross shot for the interviewer A, and then a cross shot for the interviewer B, kind of like two 45 degree angles. And normally what will happen is you'll start with two people in frame, and then you'll go to one person to the next, and you bounce back and forth between their close-ups until the interview has been wrapped up, and then you end with both people on screen again. That's a very standard video production setup. Of course, let me quickly show you the lighting. So what we have here is some LED lighting setup. In fact, we have two backlights. So LED setup here, where we're just getting a hair light for one, a hair light for two. We're adapting our normal setup with some new sets. We have some blue Philips Hue lights, shooting some blue onto the back of this red that really makes it feel new age and pop. And then over here we have what's called an LED Fresnel light up top here. These are allow us to shoot from above and shoot from a farther angle and really focus the light in. So we've really got more than 3-point lighting, because a lot of times when people think about 3-point lighting, it's for a single person. So when you do 3-point lighting for two or three people, you may need 5-6 lights to properly capture a whole studio set like this. So that is our 3-camera setup for interviews. It really looks professional. Let's show you some of what it looks like in the interview itself. So if you have a piece of advice for a customer who might be looking into your services, you know, maybe leave us with some advice and then let people know how to contact you, because it sounds like you're one of the first people we've interviewed who's really looking at this from a goal perspective, from a workflow perspective, from a more high level, not just offering video production services or broadcasting services, some of the other people we've interviewed. You're looking at it more from like a workflow perspective, figuring out which pieces of the puzzle that the certain business needs to put together in a kind of larger perspective. So how would you help people kind of put this, like you said, lots of tools, lots of different things out there. How would you help them kind of demystify? I mean, that's what you do, essentially.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say, Paul, that is the service I offer, is helping demystify the digital world. But, you know, you asked me how I would help people start. Well, that's where your cell phone is. It's a digital studio right now. You can turn it on. You can do a live video. If you're in a service industry and you're not doing live video, you're doing yourself a disservice, because you're not showing people who you are. You're not showing that human person that works, that people can connect with before they even pick up the phone, before they go to your, when they go to your website, or if they've seen you on Facebook. They get a flavor of you, and they say a picture's worth 1,000 words. I don't know how many words video's worth, but it's gotta be worth a lot.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much, and we're so happy that you all got to tune in here.